Hello, 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 and good morning. Welcome. Glory be to God to our Sunday morning worship service. I'm so excited. Hallelujah. Let us get started. We are ready to worship the Lord. Glory be to God. Are you ready? Hallelujah. Are you ready to worship the Lord God Almighty? He's so faithful. You know, He never leaves us. He never forsakes us. So let's begin and open up in prayer. Hallelujah. Let's open up in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank You. We thank You, Lord God, because You're so holy. We thank You because You're faithful. No matter what, You love us. You always draw us. You never leave us or forsake us. And we ask You to join us here today. Holy Spirit, You take over. Hallelujah. Let our worship be unto You, and let it be a sweet-smelling savor unto Your nose. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We love You. We give You all the praise. We give You all the glory, Lord. And I ask You right now, in the name of Jesus, let nothing of myself even be a show. Let nobody see me, but everybody see You, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, let You do it all. In Jesus' name, we give You all the praise and the glory. And all God's people said, amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Let us begin. Hallelujah. We're just going to hold for 1 second as my daughter gets us into Periscope. Are we on Periscope yet, my dear? Okay. Hallelujah. What we're going to do is we're going to get started worshiping. Hallelujah. Just worship with me. Hallelujah. Because we serve a mighty God. We serve a faithful God. We serve a glorious God. Da sandi ki roba la rondo go da sandi redi mira la la to sura. Ki ti rabi mira di mira la ta compa to sura. Handa ra la rondo go da suri. Kindi rondi mira rondo da sandi ki. Ti ki te la rodi di sa no da mira di mira da compa to cura. Carlo rondo go da sandi ki di mira da mira da compa to kunda. Da sandi a rombo da sandi ki di mira di mira da compa to cura. Jesus, Santa Purro, de Vide Siro. Hallelujah, la cambo sotto chiaro di Vide di Vide della tua combatto sopra. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Sindi a rondo da combatto sotto chiaro. Congo vaganda sali chiaro di Vide di Vide di Vide della combatto sopra. Oh Jesus, we love You. Hallelujah. We glorify Your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are on Periscope. Hallelujah. Welcome this morning, those of you on Facebook, those of you on Periscope, share this with your friends. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I do share with you that the Lord God is so mighty. Even this morning, we had some difficulties getting things started, and the Lord God is so faithful. Hallelujah. That He always moves forward. So I do apologize that we got started behind the eight ball late, but the Lord is faithful, and He worked out all the details. Hallelujah. He worked out all the details. I praise God. I hope and pray in the name of Jesus that you find yourself today, hallelujah, thanking the Lord God. I hope and pray that you are looking right now at the Lord and looking towards heaven, saying, thank You, Lord. No matter what things looked like around you, that you are looking towards heaven, thanking the Lord. I know I am. I know I am thanking the Lord because I'm so grateful for the Lord that I serve. I'm so grateful. Aren't you grateful that we serve a mighty God? Don't we serve a mighty, mighty, wonderful, wonderful God? Hallelujah. Because He's faithful. He's glorious. There's no one like Him. Absolutely no one like Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And He's holy glory. Hallelujah. 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 Let's just sing a song unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. Hallelujah. is so mighty. Hallelujah. We're going to switch the words. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty, you reign. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty, you reign. We love you. Tiffany, come forth and you sing. You lead. Hallelujah. Let's sing it unto the Lord. We're going to sing it again because we love the Lord God and He's so mighty. And as we sing, we'll sing it unto Him. Glory be to God. We'll sing it unto Him. Let all of your problems, let everything just melt away. And just lift up your hands and worship Him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. Hallelujah.
Let's sing, great is our thy faithfulness.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father.
Hallelujah.
There is no shadow
of
turning with thee.
Oh, you're the same, Lord.
Thou changes not.
Great
is thy faith.
song.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee.
Hallelujah.
Thou changest not thy compassion.
Jesus.
They fail not.
Hallelujah. Faith, knowing who you are in us And we are in you. Oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, we love you, Lord.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I love you, Lord. And we lift our voice to worship you, oh, my soul. Give us a clean heart, O God, and renew our right spirit within us. Make in us a clean heart, O God, and we worship you, Lord. Oh, we love you, Lord, for we worship you, Lord. Oh, we love you, Lord. Making us a clean heart, O God. Making us a clean heart. Making us a clean heart, O God. We love you. For we worship you with all our hearts today. Making us a clean heart, O God. We worship you. For we love you, Lord. Oh, we love you, Lord. Sing with me, saints. For we love you, Lord. For we love you, Lord. Oh, we love you, Lord. For we love you, Lord. For we love you, Lord. Oh, we love you, Lord. Making us a clean heart, O God. Making us a clean heart, O God. Making us a clean heart, O God. Cleanse our hearts. Making us a clean heart, O God. Making us a clean heart, O God. Making us a clean heart, O God. We love you, Lord. Making us a clean heart, O God. Renew our right spirit in us. Making us a clean heart, O God. Renew our spirits. Making us a clean heart, O God. Renew our right spirit in us. Making us a clean heart, O God. Renew our right spirit. You are our holy Lord. We put no other before you. You are our holy Lord. We worship you. You are our holy Lord. We put no one else before you. You are holy, Lord, for we worship you. Oh, Lord, we come before you today because we love you. We love and we honor you and we thank you, Lord Jesus, that you are mighty. You are holy, and I ask you right now that you will just take over this place as we worship and come before you, Lord God. And it's all about you. We give this time over to you, Lord Jesus, because we love you. We are before you, and you are mighty, Lord God. You are mighty, Lord God. We give you all of our praise and all of the glory, Lord. And as we come before you, Lord God, I ask you right now,
yes,
that you, Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus, will speak through me. Let not one ounce of me show through. Let it all be for your glory. Let every word be a word that is yours, that comes from you. In Jesus' precious name, we thank you. Touch every heart today.
Yes, Lord.
Renew every heart afresh, Lord. Fill each one with your Holy Spirit. Touch each one with a new and fresh anointing. In Jesus' name, fill our hearts, Lord, afresh. In Jesus' name, we thank you. And all God's people said amen.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, the Lord is so faithful. I'm so grateful to the Lord our God. What a mighty, wonderful Lord God we serve. Don't we serve some God that is, we don't serve some God that is deaf to our problems and to our situations. We don't serve some God who can't hear us. We don't serve some God who doesn't come. He's not an ever-present help. We serve a mighty God who is solid. He doesn't change. He never leaves. He never goes. He never shifts. He is always wonderful. He is always love. Hallelujah. He is always on your side. No matter what it is, he is always on your side. He will teach you.
Amen.
He will rebuke you. He will correct you. He will change and shift you because he's always on your side. I can trust in the Lord God. You can trust in him because you know, no matter where you go, he's not going to stand back and say nothing. He's going to stand with you, and he's going to gently turn you. And he's always going to gently turn you. You know, my daughter was telling me one day about a story. I thought about this a long time ago, and I was talking to someone one day. I was talking to my brother, and he wasn't saved. So, you know, if he wasn't saved, he didn't understand the things of God. And sometimes the things I would say, he would baffle him. And he would just ask me, and we would talk about it. And I remember him saying to me one day, he said, you know, I don't remember how we got on the situation or on the subject, but I told him, if you did something wrong, he said, he said, what would you do? You know, would you lie for me? And I said, no, I would never lie for you. And he said, but I'm your brother, Michelle. I'm your brother. This is blood, Michelle. And I said, listen, I love you dearly. I love you. But no, I would stand with you. And the way I would stand with you is if you did something wrong, if you did something against the law, I would call the police. And I would be right there with you. I would be right there with you through the whole thing. But yes, I would be right there with you in the right way. And he said, but Michelle, I'm your brother. How could you say it? How could you do something like that? I'm your brother. Whatever you do, I would be right with you. And I said, no, that's not the right way. Whatever you do, I'm going to stand right there with you. And I'm going to do what's right for you. You see, I'm not God. And by no stretch of any imagination can I pretend to be. But all I know is what I see God do for me. And when I'm wrong, he will turn things around in my heart. And I'm so grateful for that. When you're wrong, he will turn things around in your heart. We must have faith, glory be to God, that he will do that. See, if we know that the Lord God is faithful, then we know no matter what is happening in your lives, whatever is going on in your life, he's going to take care of it. He's not going to stand by and watch you fall away. That example I gave you, if I stood with my brother and I did the wrong thing with him, let's say, I don't know, he robbed a bank, and I love my brother, there's no question about that. I love all my family. If I loved him and I said, and the police officer said, you know, what happened? Where was your brother last night? And if I said, well, he was with me, but he wasn't, he was out robbing a bank, how could I be standing with him? Because you know what would happen is his heart condition would get worse, and it would get worse. So sometimes we have to hit rock bottom before we can stand and look up before the Lord. Some people, not everyone has to do that. But we have to hit some sort of bottom, some sort of bottom. I've heard stories where people have talked about all kinds of rock bottoms that they've hit. And some people have to hit it. And maybe that would have been him, but if I didn't stand for him in the Lord, I would have been standing in front of God, you see. I would have been holding God away from him because the Lord God might have used that to get to his heart. I don't know, I'm not God. In fact, who am I to decide when God will choose to bring someone to him? Who am I? No one. I'm nobody. I am a servant of the Lord. That's all I am. So my words, my life, everything I say is to glorify God. So when I see someone in wrong, my job is to correct them in love. It's my job. It's your job too. The Bible says so. I have faith, and I have the faith to understand that God will turn them around. If I said to my brother, whatever you do, I'll lie for you. If you need me to steal for you, I'll steal for you. If you need me to say that you weren't there, I'll say that you weren't there. I would be hurting him. Could never get to his heart. Not he couldn't use me if I was willing to make my brother an idol. You see? If I put my love for my family before the Lord God, how much do I really love him? Is it really about the Lord or is it about family? I used to say family is everything. I knew, and I put those words in quotations, that that's all I had. I always knew that. But I came to learn that your family is human. Oh, they love you. There's no question about that. You might have a family member that doesn't love you. And I'm not talking about that. You know, I've heard testimonies about people whose parents hated them. That's not what I mean. Okay, that's not what I mean. What I mean is most of us have family that love us, but they make mistakes or they make bad choices. Nobody can replace the Lord God that you serve. Your family can't replace him. Family is not everything. God is everything. Your family can't save you, can they? Your family can't give you salvation, can they? David said that the Holy Spirit, he said, would be with him in hell. That's where he made his bed. Read it. It's in Psalms. It blew my mind when I first read that. I said, what? How can the Holy Spirit do that? I don't understand. I still don't understand. But the Bible says, the Lord will never leave us or forsake us. The Lord will never leave us or forsake us. That's what he says. And his word is true. Hallelujah. My friends, God is everything. When we look at his word, hallelujah, we see that men and women of God, they left their family to serve God. Oh, my Lord God. They left their families to serve God. Some did, some didn't. But they followed whatever the Lord God told them to follow. Are you willing? Are you willing to do that? There may come a time in your life that the Lord tells you, you've got to leave. I'm going to correct it. There will probably come a time in your life when the Lord God says, you've got to leave those that were familiar to you, those that were around you. It may be your family. It may be your friends. I heard a pastor say that there was a young boy, a young man, that used to work for his ministry. My pastor said this story. Actually, just a couple of days ago, and I could understand it. The boy was 18 or 19 years old, and he had been addicted to drugs. And the Lord God delivered him from drug addiction. And the boy was serving the Lord. And I say the boy because he's 18, 19. He's still, that's still a boy. That's still a boy. I know I was a young girl when I was that age. And my pastor said to him, whatever his name was, I don't know what the kid's name was. And he said, let's just say, it doesn't even matter. He said, why don't you go back? The boy lived in Florida somewhere. He said, why don't you go back and just, why don't you go live with your mom? I mean, you know, you and your mom, you can help take care of and help take care of things. And I guess he was thinking, you know, he's a young boy. I mean, his mom can share expenses and, you know, there's nothing wrong. I guess maybe his mom was single or something. I don't know. Widowed. I don't know. And the boy said, oh, no, 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 I can't go back there. He said, if I go back there, all those same demons that kept me and almost killed me back then will be there waiting for me and they will kill me if I go back there. He said, I can never go back there. I cannot go back and live there. I know what he's saying. And I think you know what I'm saying too. You can't go back to there, whatever that place is. You've got to keep your eyes on the Lord. I want you to turn with me to Hebrews 11. Now, I want you to keep your finger there for a second. Because you see, the Lord God has a plan for each and every one of you today. And the plan that he has for you is a sovereign plan. And no matter what it is that everybody around you thinks, you've got to keep your eyes on him. You must have faith, recognizing that he is the one who will lead you and never forsake you. And if you follow God, you will never, ever fail. You will have victory in the Lord Jesus Christ if you will follow him. If you will follow him. If you will follow him, and only if you will follow him. There's no victory in yourself. There's no victory in if I just say the right things. There's no victory in I'm going to say the right words every day when I wake up. There's no victory in I'm going to stand in front of the mirror and I'm going to repeat these words that I'm good enough, I'm wonderful enough, I'm not. No, there's no victory in I'm a good person. There's no victory in everything is going to be fine because I know that if I just think positively, everything will work out. No, those are lies from the pit of hell. And you see, they almost sound like scripture. Almost. I used to go to a church once a long time ago. And what I didn't realize about this church was that there was something wrong. I didn't see it. I actually saw it at first. But I told myself I wasn't seeing it. Maybe you've been here before. I went to this church. I knew what the Lord had shown me. I had been growing in the things of God. And I went to this church, and things looked wonderful. And I felt freedom. And I thought, this is fantastic. And I remember hearing the sermon, and everything sounded almost right. Just a little bit different. Just a little bit different. And I told myself, no. Let me use the right word. Everything was a little bit off. Like this much. And if you weren't strong in the Lord, you wouldn't have even seen that little bit off. But I kept going, and I said to myself, no, it has to be me. It must be just me. I was still very young in my walk. I said, it has to be me. So I looked around, and everybody else seemed to be loving the Lord, and it seemed to be working. And I even had a friend who had invited me to the church in the first place. She's the one, well, she didn't invite me. She told me about it. And I told you before, I just go where I think I want to go. So I went. Nobody had to tell me. She was shocked to see me there because I just want things of God. I want the Lord. So I showed up. And I remember saying, this is awesome. I had come from a place where there was a lot of legalism. And so I said, oh, this is what I want. This must be great. This must be good. And a little bit, let me just tell you this. Let me. I don't even have to go into any more. Something was just a little bit off, and a little bit is enough. A little bit off is enough, my friends. A little bit off is enough. I had to leave that church. And the reason I left, the way I left that church, the little bit was enough to leave that church. I won't even go into all the details, but I will tell you this. When I left that church, I sat down with the pastor because I know that that's the right way to handle things. When if you leave a church, you leave in order. I don't care how wrong or right anybody else is, but you do things in order, and everything you do it in service unto the Lord Jesus, right? That's what we do. So I sat down with that pastor, who was a very nice man. He really was. And what came out of his mouth, I didn't expect. I didn't understand why things were a little bit off. And when I had that conversation with him, the Lord showed me why things had been so, it looked like a little bit off, but they were way off. They were way off. So that pastor said to me, you know, and I'm paraphrasing here, I don't want to quote him, and I'm not going to say his name because I'm not here to bash a man of God. And I pray that the Lord God has changed that man's heart. That's between him and him. What I'm here to tell you is, you've got to have faith and listen to what the word of what the Lord God tells you in 100% entirety. You cannot sway. You've got to have faith, understanding that everything he said is true. Everything. So this is what the pastor said to me. He said, you know, I understand why you're leaving. And that sounded wonderful to me. Whether he said that or not, I would have left because I knew in my spirit I needed to go. But he said, I understand why you're leaving. He said, but you know, we wouldn't say anything to anyone because he said, a long time ago, when I first started this church, he said, we used to do things exactly the way Scripture said. And then we did things exactly the way Scripture said, and the things fell apart right before us. So we realized that that couldn't have been what God meant. So we kind of make our own choices and kind of go back and forth about what we think the Lord might really mean. My friends, that is exactly what he said. And that is exactly what I'm telling you, and you didn't hear me wrong. And that was a pastor, my friend. You see, you've got to have faith, recognizing that the Holy Spirit is going to lead you. You go somewhere and it seems a little bit off, get out of there. I had a friend. I'm not going to tell it. I'm telling you, I can tell you some stories that would curl your own hair. Because the Lord is so faithful and he's gotten me out of situations. See, my love for the Lord has been one that has been where I have said I just want God so much that if it looks right, I'm going to be right there. Instead of, Lord God, what are you saying to me? Wait a minute. Something seems a little off. Instead of me saying at those times in my walk, I believe you, Holy Spirit, and it doesn't matter to me what everybody else looks like, and they all seem to be happy, and they all seem to be understanding, and everybody else, I mean everybody in that church was saying amen. I was the only one squirming in my chair, in my seat, feeling like I needed to run out of there. But I didn't, my friends, until a while later. It took me almost a year to get out of that place. And I say get out of that place because I just wouldn't listen to the Holy Spirit. I kept telling myself I was not right, that I wasn't hearing the Lord. I was wrong and it must be just me. No, the Holy Spirit will never leave you or forsake you. The Holy Spirit will always tell you exactly what's right. He will always, 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 things will always ring true in your spirit. You've got to have faith. This word that we have here, everything is true in it. There's nothing in it that's wrong. Absolutely nothing. I'm going to take you right here, because in verse 1 of Hebrews chapter 11, the Lord God tells us what faith is. And why is it important? Why am I connecting those two? Because, my friends, if you believe what the Word of God says, no matter what's going on around you, you will not fall prey to the enemy's plans. Because even in the Bible, there were people that the Word of God said had been placed inside churches to cause people to fall astray. The enemy is everywhere. The enemy comes in the church. Don't you know that? Don't you understand that? The enemy comes in the church so that people will be swayed. The enemy is sitting sometimes working in the person right next to you in the pew. Don't you know that? The Bible tells us to be faithful, to have faith in what he says. Hebrews 11:1 says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Wait a minute. If you look around in the church you're in, and you look at the pulpit and everybody, something just isn't right. It's not right. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Everybody around you is saying, oh, this is right. No, you're just, no. Everything is right. This is right. He just loves God. And oh, well, you know, he just sometimes gets a little excited. And no, my friends. The Holy Spirit said in his word that he will lead you and guide you in all things. All things. Where's your faith if you don't trust that? I had to repent when I left that church because I was not listening to the Holy Spirit. And it got worse, friends. Oh, it was bad. The enemy, I had a friend who said to me, she visited the church. She left in the middle of the church service. She ran out of there. She flew out of there. And I came to see her. She did my taxes. And she said to me, Michelle, how's it going? And I said, oh, everything's going great. Praise God. She said, still going to that church? That one, you know, that I'm visiting? I said, oh, my heavens. Oh, no. Praise God. She said, I'm so glad. She said, how did you end up in that place? Because she didn't want to say, I guess she didn't want to say, I wish she would have said, but the Lord said, I hope you follow what I just said. I said that about three different ways. She didn't want to say, I wish she would have said, but I'm glad the Lord said. The Lord delivered me out of that place. And I'm so grateful that he did, because you see, the Holy Spirit is going to move. He will lead you in all things. She said, how could you end up in that place, Michelle? You, I know you. You love the Lord. How? What happened? I said, sister, these are mine. I can't repeat exactly what I said. Not that it was bad. Not that it was filthy. Nothing like that. I just don't need to say it. But what I did tell her was, I thank God that he opened up my eyes. And she said, I'm thankful too. She said, I was praying for you, sister. She said, I've been praying for you. Now let me tell you something, my friends. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained a good report. My friends, you can't serve God if you're looking at what's around you. Right here. Right here. I'm talking to somebody right now. The Lord won't let me leave this point. You cannot serve God if you're looking at all the things going on around you. You can't. If you look at everything around you, it will distract you. It will dupe you. It will trick you. It will lead you astray. The things around you have been put around you and have been designed to keep you from serving God. I'm not talking about what God put with you, because the things that the Lord God does is he will move in you, within your spirit, man. And he'll send a man or woman of God to say, what are you doing? He'll send a man or woman of God to say, I love you, brother, but you are wrong. He'll send a man or woman of God to say, sister, you are so dear to me, and this is what the Lord God Almighty has told me to tell you. Get out of there. Stop what you're doing. Hallelujah. You know, I've had friends who have said those things to me. I'm a strong person. My personality is one where I don't budge very easily. That's been my whole makeup. God made me this way. And it's a good thing, because you can't be a leader if you fall astray very easily. So with that said, there have been many times where I was in pride, and the Lord God had to send another bold sister or brother to say to me, and always mostly sisters, actually, mostly sisters, and they would come to me and say, you're wrong. Sister, you're wrong. The Lord came and told me, the Lord told me to tell you, you're wrong. And I would stop, and I would, what do you mean? Sister, listen, can I talk to you for a second? Let me say this to you right now, saints. Can I talk to you for a second? You've been wrong. You've been looking at things the wrong way. Can I talk to you for a second? I've had many, many men and women of God who I'm so grateful that the Lord God has come to me and said, sister, you've been wrong. And I'm talking when I was a Christian. They've said, sister, you've been wrong. See, nobody came to me when I wasn't serving the Lord. And nobody's going to come to you when you're not serving the Lord, because the enemy wants to keep you where you are. The enemy wants to keep you out of the hands of God. The enemy wants to keep you in hell, because that's where you are if you're not serving the Lord. You're already there if you're not serving the Lord. Already. The Bible says that we damn ourselves. When we reject Jesus Christ, we've already been damned. That's what the Bible says. Nobody has to do it for you. You do it yourself. So those of you, those who have not served God, nobody's going to come and say, you've been wrong, because if you have someone doing that, that's the work of the Lord God. But you're probably, people, they stay in their sin. When I was in my sin, nobody came to me and said, you're wrong. But it's when I got saved. You see, because the Lord God knew. He knew that I needed to hear it. When I was, before Jesus, I was called strong-willed. That was called prideful, stubborn. Now I can say strong in the Lord. But there have been many times when I needed someone and the Lord God knew. I needed to hear someone come to me and the Lord God used them to correct me. The Bible says that he'll use his word to correct you. Can I talk to you for a second? I'm here to share with you that you need to shift what you're doing right now. You're not living fully for the Lord. There are secrets that you have that you think are secret. And maybe they're secret to people around you. Nobody around you can see it. Maybe one or two people can see it. Maybe your wife or your husband sees it, or your mama, because she's been praying for you. Maybe she sees it, but nobody else can see it. Everybody else is calling you a great man of God, a great woman of God. But you and I both know right now there's a secret that you're holding on to. And as long as you won't let go of that, the Lord God cannot move fully through your life. You see, God won't let me. He told me something to share today, to teach about today, but he won't let me stop until I say this to you, whoever you are. The Lord God does not want you to continue. Give it over to him. You're not hiding it from him. The Lord God knows. He knows everything, friend. Sweet saint, he knows it all. You're not hiding anything from him. And the best part is, he wants you to be delivered from that thing. See, that thing has been tearing you up inside. That thing's been holding you back. Every time you go to take a step forward, the enemy says, see, you still got that thing going. See, you can't because you have that thing. That's what the enemy says. But that's not what God said. God said, let it go. Repent right now. And God said, and I will turn you in the right direction. That's what he says. He will always send a man or woman of God to move you in the right direction. He will send a man or woman of God to change your trajectory. Glory be to God. You see, this is what he always does through scripture. He's done it in my life, and he's doing it in your life. Glory be to God. Whatever it is that you've been holding on to, that thing you've been hiding, let it go. Stop it. Just stop it now. And let God move in your life. He loves you. The Bible tells us, glory be to God, that it's time to stand and to turn away from the old things. We're not like children any longer. It's time to grow up and to stand up in the things of God and to serve him. See, the Bible tells us, hallelujah, that nobody around us is going to be, we're not going to be held accountable to the people around us. It's not those people around us that you're accountable to. One day you'll stand before your maker, and let me tell you, that day is coming very soon. That day is almost here, and I do mean almost here. Some have said, should I say it, Lord? Should I say it? I don't know if you're ready for this, my friend. Okay, I'm not going to say it, but let me just tell you this. The Lord will be here soon. You know it in your spirit. I'm not telling you something new. You know it. I believe you know it. You sense the urgency to get things right. What's going to happen when the Lord Jesus comes back? Are you going to miss the rapture? Are are you going to miss the rapture? When Jesus comes back, he's coming back for a church, his bride, that's without spot or wrinkle. Without spot or wrinkle, what does it mean? If you look in the book of Revelations, let me take you there right now. Hold your spot in Hebrews, put a little pen there, put a little mark there. The book of Revelations, glory be to God. This is what he says. Hallelujah. In Revelations chapter 19, it says, "And after these things, I heard a great voice of much people in heaven saying, Alleluia." Go right there with me, friends. Revelations 19. It says, "And after these things, I heard a great voice of much people in heaven saying, Alleluia. Salvation and glory and honor and power unto the Lord our God. For true and righteous are his judgments. For he hath judged the great whore." Please forgive me. There is a sound. I don't know if you can hear it. I hope that you can. We live in an apartment and they apparently are cleaning our hallways. So it'll stop. Just please. I apologize. And it says, "And after these things, I heard a great voice of much people in heaven saying, Alleluia, salvation and glory and honor and power unto the Lord our God. For true and righteous are his judgments. For he hath judged the great whore, which did corrupt the earth with her fornication, and hath avenged the blood of his servants at her hand. And again they said, Alleluia, and her smoke rose up forever and ever. And the 24 elders and the 4 beasts fell down and worshiped God that sat on the throne, saying, Amen, Alleluia. And a voice came out of the throne, saying, Praise our God, all ye his servants, and ye that fear him, both small and great. And I heard as it were the voice of a great multitude, and as the voice of many waters, and as the voice of mighty thundering, saying, Alleluia. For the Lord God omnipotent reigneth. Let us be glad and rejoice and give honor to him, for the marriage of the Lamb is come, and his wife hath made herself ready. We are his wife. And the Bible says, in order for us to be ready, we must make our hearts ready. Glory be to God. Our hearts must be ready. Is your heart ready? And he saith unto me in verse 9, write, blessed are they which are called unto the marriage supper of the Lamb. And saith unto me, these are the true sayings of God. Hallelujah. Let me take you somewhere else. Glory be to God. Take you somewhere else. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And in Revelation chapter 1, verse 7, it says, behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him. Even so. Amen. My friends, are you going to be ready? Will you be ready? When he comes, he's coming. He's coming back. Behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see him. And they also which pierced him, and all kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him. Even so, amen. Friends, it's time for you to get ready. Get your hearts ready. The Bible says that there will be many people who will fall away. When the Lord God is on his way back, it says there's going to be a great falling away. It's happening right now. Look to the right of you. Look to the left of you. There are people who you thought served God and you saw something and you realized that they never did. Or that they're not serving God anymore. And you're shocked and you're amazed. Stop being shocked and stop being amazed and look to the things of God right now. So that you are not one of those people that fall away. It said in his word, he said, make ready. It's a choice that you have. It's a decision, my friends. A decision. Why? Why? Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Woo! Ho, ho, ho. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let me take you somewhere here. Glory be to God. You see, there's a battle happening right now for your soul. There's a battle happening right now for those of you that are not ready. Make your heart ready. It's time today for you to say, Lord God, I'm going to serve you with everything. Can I sit down? Can I talk to you about something? Let me just pull up a chair for a second. Let me just tell you. God is not surprised. There's no secret that you have from him. He sees it all. And he wants you to get rid of that thing. You can call it whatever you want. I'm leaving a blank. It's time to get rid of it. Let it go. Excuse me. Let it go. Thank you, Tiffany. Let it go. Let it go. If you will let go of all of the things that the enemy is bound you with right now. In fact, let's just stop right now and let's pray. Glory be to God. Let us pray because God is so faithful. He's so faithful. There's something that you've been holding on to. And I'm going to just sit quietly for a minute. Right now, you're standing here and you're saying, I think you're talking to me. Pastor, you're talking to me. I want to pray with you. I want to pray with you right now. I want to pray with you right now because the Lord God is faithful. And he's been waiting for this moment. Glory be to God. And he's been calling you in your heart. You've been feeling and hearing him. Hallelujah. Now's the right time.
Hallelujah.
Now's the right time. Will you pray with me, my friends? Hallelujah. You that have been holding on to the old things, saying, I love God. But you know there's things that you didn't give over. The Bible calls you the backslider, my friends. There's things that you have been giving that you've not given fully to the Lord. If he doesn't have all of you, the Bible says if you don't love him with everything in your heart, everything, if you won't surrender everything over to him, you're not his, my friends. Jesus said it clearly so many ways. So there was no question. If you will not follow him, if you will not obey Jesus, then you are not a Christian. You are not his. It's time to repent.
Yes.
I hear the Lord saying, repent. Glory be to God. Repent. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Oh, dear Heavenly Father.
Yes, hallelujah.
We come before you right now because we repent, Lord God. We love you and we want you to take over our whole hearts.
Yes.
We want you to take over everything, Lord God. There's nothing that we want to hold on to anymore. We don't want to hold on to it anymore. We give it all over to you, Lord. Right now, I give it to you.
Yes.
Saints, I want you to repeat this with me.
I give everything in my life to you, Jesus.
Lord God, take over.
Lord God, take over.
I give you my whole heart.
I give you my whole heart.
Will you make in me a clean heart, O God?
Will you make in me a clean heart, O God?
Cleanse me with your blood, Lord.
Cleanse me with your blood, Lord.
I repent.
I repent.
I give it all to you.
I give it all to you.
Forgive me for holding on to those things.
Forgive me for holding on to those things.
Oh, I love you, Lord.
Oh, I love you, Lord.
And today I choose to serve you.
And today I choose to serve you.
I want you to take every wicked thing.
I want you to take every wicked thing.
Everything that doesn't please you within my life.
Everything that doesn't please you within
take
my
it
life.
Out. Get
take
rid
it
of
out.
It,
get
Lord.
Rid of it, Lord.
Take it out of me
take
right
it
now.
Out of me right now.
Get rid of it, Lord.
Get rid of it.
Pull it up by its root, Lord.
By its root, Lord.
Pull it up by the root and rip it out, Lord.
Root,
I don't want that anymore.
I don't want it anymore.
I choose you for
choose
everything
you
in my life.
Everything in my life. Hallelujah.
I love you, Lord.
I love you, Lord.
And from today, I choose to serve
today,
you.
I choose to serve you.
With my whole heart.
With my whole heart.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. My friends, you see, God has a plan for each and every one of us, and he wants us to see what that plan is. It's not his love to hold it back from us, not his plan that we should be completely in the dark. We're children of the light. He gives us things. He reveals things to us. He shows us things. The world doesn't see it, but you and I, we're children of the light, and he shows us things. Mm-hmm. love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. Worship it with me, my friends. Worship it. We love you, Lord. Oh, how we love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. Oh, we love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. Glory to your name. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We love you. We love you. We love you, Lord. We love you. Oh, we love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. Glory to your name, Lord. We love you. We love you. My friends, we serve a wonderful God. We serve a mighty God. He's so faithful. He's so faithful. When we hold on to Him, He won't drop us. He won't forget about us. He won't turn away from us. He's always there. He's always there. Always, my friends, always. My friends, we're going to close here today. But God has done a mighty work within you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Glory be to God. Lord God, I thank you for what you've done here today. Yes. Oh, Lord, you are so holy. And we love and we lift your name up above every name, Lord, in the name of Jesus. For you are glorious. Oh, yes, Lord, we love you. There's no one like you. Go with each one here today as they leave, Lord God. Oh, Lord. Touch each person, Lord God, in every area of their life. Give them wisdom, Lord God, that you may get the glory and all the honor, Lord. In the name of Jesus, I plead the blood over each one today. I plead the blood of Jesus over each one today, right now, over their families and their lives and their, Lord, their properties, glory, their finances, Lord God. Their jobs and ministries, oh Lord, work in and through them. And over their children, glory be to God. I plead the blood of Jesus over their relationships, every relationship, every godly relationship that you've put in their lives. And over all of their realms of influence, Lord. Hallelujah. I ask you to enlarge their realms of influence in Jesus' name. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. And all God's people said amen. Hallelujah. My friends, I want to thank you so much for joining me. The Lord God is so faithful. You see, if we will obey Him, He will change things. He got the glory today. He gets the glory. And let's do that. Let's give Him the glory for the rest of our lives, today and moving forward. The kingdom of heaven is right here, right now. I love you. I will see you tomorrow. Hallelujah. 3:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Glory be to God.